Friends, welcome to the series of production management. Today we are going to explore another important topic in production management, that is product development and profit maximization. As you all know that for all the organization, profit is very variable, as all the business lies or revolves around the profit. As you all know, in simple languages, whenever the selling price is more than the cost price, we get the profit. The difference is known as the profit. So overall, in a production management system, the development of a product, the cost at which we are going to develop the product, depends upon the MRP which we are going to put of that specific product. And that MRP is all what it covers the cost of that product, from raw material to the final reach up to the customer. So here, two of the most important topics, that is profit maximization and product development, we are going to see, because product is somewhat very important, as the customer is going to attract by the product which is being developed by a specific company. Now see that what is profit maximization. According to Peter Drucker, profit is a condition of survival. It is the cost of the future, the cost of staying in the business. Thus, profit should be planned and managed properly. Means somewhere or other, when an organization has to be in the business, has to be in the market, it must plan a profit system that is a unique. It must have a structure in which he is going to implement and get the profit. Because for the survival of any company, the profit plays an important role. Then profit planning lays under foundation for the future income statement of the organization. Means it is a planning system by which we are going to deal with our financial structure. Because every company wants profit. And on this profit, you are going to give, get and arrange your resources. So profit is something which is very important for any organization for its survival. Now let's see, there are four steps by which we can say that we are going to plan the profit planning process. So how you are going to plan the profit? The first one is establishing profit goals. That according to the product, what is the cost of the product and what is the profit you required, so that overall system of the work is going to be done. As you all know, for any organization, four important pillars are very important. Marketing, finance, human resource management, product development. Apart from this, logistic and transportation, supply chain management also comes here. So each and every step should be properly done, and according to that, established goals will be set so that we can achieve our profit. Then determining expected sales volume. If we are saying that if we are making any product, so what is the sale volume which is being required in the market? Means what is the demand of that specific product in the market? Then estimating expenses. What are the cost of raw material? What are the cost of the machineries which is being required to make it final output? What is the cost of logistic and supply chain, transportation cost? The different taxes which the company has to pay. So everything should be properly taken over here and must be properly estimated. And the last one is determining estimated profit. After you know that this is our cost price, you are going to put your MRP, and on that MRP you are going to get the sale price. So your selling price should always be more than your cost price, and the difference between the cost price and the selling price is your profit. The more the profit, the more the organization growth is. Now, explore the tools for production development and the profit maximization. As we are talking about the profit, so the profit depends upon the product. As you all know that the product is one of the most important thing which a customer directly sees and being attracted towards that. For example, if you are going to buy a toothbrush, there are different type of toothbrush. But there are certain things which attracts you. So there are four qualities on which a product is being attracted and being bought by the customer. The first one is standardized. means it must have some standard quality. Then it must have got simplified process. Then it must perform some specialized function. Then the last one is that there is a scope of diversification in that specific process. So if a product follows and accepts all these four norms, the product is highly acceptable in the market. If we take an example of a television, you can see that there are different companies who are making televisions. So here you have to see that there is a specific standard size of a television. So standardization come over here. There are certain standard norms which the companies has to follow. Then you have got simplified process. The more simpler you have to operate that specific television, the more it is being acceptable to the customer. Then specialized. Every company has some specialized process, specialized activity on his product. So it is also been taken over here. And the last one is diversification, means as you all know that in the past era, you have got a big TV, a box of TV is there. Now you have got flat screen TV, LED, LCDs, TVs are there. You have got now small TVs over here. They can perform multiple operations at a specific time. So there is a scope of diversification also. So now see that what is standardization? Standardization means the fixation of some appropriate size, shape, quality, manufacturing process, weight, and other characteristics as standard to manufacture a product of desired variety and utility. Means there must have a specific size. You have to fix certain quality, the shape, the manufacturing process, the weight. It must have a certain standard process. And on that standard process, the company has to manufacture his product. So I have given you the example of television. Another example is of shaving blades. As you see, that you take the blade of any company, it has got a specific size, weight, standard, because you have to put it in a specific machine. So it has got a standard size. You take the mosquito repellents, it has got a standard size. So everything you take, there must have got a specific standard size. So the companies have to follow certain standard process. Now what is the advantages of standardization? The first one is it tries to eliminate the wastage and reduces the cost of production. Automatically, when you have got the standardized process, the cost of wastage is reduced and the cost of production is reduced. Then standardized product component reduces the old cost, permit larger and more economical lot size of production, avoid losses of obsolescence and reduces capital requirement for the work in process. Means whenever there is work in process, so automatically if you have got a standardized system, your work will be properly done and it reduces the cost of wastage. Then production in larger quantities can be planned, which results in a better production unit. When you are working for a larger quantity, it is one of the best systems which the companies can adopt. Service and maintenance costs as well as the marketing expenses are reduced. Means if you have got standard system, standard product, automatically the service cost is being reduced. There are a lot of companies who used to make the product in a standard system so that they required least service center. Then encourages the manufacturer to product the new style, use and performance with object to generate more customer. And if you have got a standardized product, automatically customers are more attracted toward that and they attract toward the standard qualities which the company used to give. Then the value of a standardized product lying in the stock transport can be easily purposed for advancing loan. If you have got a standard product, automatically the banks who are going to finance the company, they know that the company has got a good reputation in the market. So companies can easily avail loan by the help of making and manufacturing a standard product. Now, what are the disadvantages of standardization? The first one is affects worker efficiency. As you all know that in a standardized product, you have to follow a routine activity. You have to follow, there is less scope of innovation. So somewhere or the other, the efficiency of the worker is directly affected because they have to follow a routine activity daily in their work. Then spirit of challenges vanishes. As I have told you that there is a less scope of research and development, there is a less scope of innovation. So the spirit of challenges vanishes over here from the customer point of view or the employee point of view. Not suitable for new product as a lot of changes has to be made. Whenever a new product is going to be launched, he is not going to maintain the standardized process because for every new product, there is a maximum chances of getting that product up to the standard quality. So standardization is not meant for the new product which is being there in the market. And the last one is not suitable for the small firm. All the firms who are very small cannot apply a standardization process because a standardization process required a lot of cost. Next, simplification. By word itself says that you have to make a product which is very simple to be used by the customer. Simplification refers to the elimination of superfluous varieties, size, dimensions, etc. Means whenever you are going to make a product which is being very easy to be used by a customer, you can say that you have made a simplified system for the customer. Now you have seen that there are a lot of automatic cars which are there in the market. This has helped the customer to have a proper system to operate the car without gear. So it has simplified the process of driving a car. So more you simplify the process, the more actively the customer used to buy the product. Now, what is the advantages of the simplification? Eliminated surplus use of material provides economy in the production cost. Means whatever there is an extra surplus use of inventories, it can be avoided and the product can be made in a simplified process. Then less obsolescence of materials and machinery. Means here when you have got a simplified process, your machinery and material will be less used or less wastage. Efficiency of the production process increases. As you know that you are making a simplified process, your efficiency and your production automatically increase. Human efforts become more productive due to the scope of better training and learning facility with simplified operations. As you have made a process into a very simplified manner, the efficiency of an individual, that is your human resource, increases, as well as your process on the machine also increases. After sales services, prospects are minimized. As you have got simplified process, the customer knows how to operate it, so there is less chances of getting the product destroyed or there is some problem in the product. So when there is no problem in the product, so after sales services automatically reduces. Then production planning and control operations become easy and simple. Here the production planning system is very easier because we have applied the simplified process. Then reduction in cost production leads to more sale. When the cost of production decreases, the cost of sales of product decreases. Automatically there is a demand of the product in the market and there is a more sale of that product in that specific market. To jobber, wholesaler and retailers. Means all the person who are dealing in the middle of a life cycle or the cycle of a system, you are going to say that whether it is jobber who is keeping the product, warehouser who is keeping the product, they have got less time or the less money required to keep the product over there because there is a lot of demand of the product in the market. Increased turnover. Automatically, when you have got a simplified product, there is a demand of that product in the market. So automatically, that turnover increases. Sales effort of fewer items. The effort for the sales, the salesman has to explain the product in a very easy manner and it being acceptable to the market and to the customer. Reduction in shortage spaces. Means you have to keep less space because the product when it is being made is automatically distributed in the market and toward the final destination. And the last one is less overheads and handling expenditure. As you all know, I have told you that warehousing cost is reduced, transportation cost is reduced, warehousing, every cost is being reduced. Simplified product requires less raw material and the cost of raw material also reduces. So automatically there is a less overheads and the handling expenditure. Now the third point is very important. The third point is specialization. Specialization implies expertise in some particular areas or field. It is the experience that as the companies expand the range of their products, manufacturing system involves more and operations for transforming inputs into outputs. Means whenever we talk about the specialization, we talk about certain product who are being specialized by that specific features. If you are going to buy a mobile, so you have got different mobiles in the market. Some people like the storage, some people like the camera, some people like the gaming activity. So as per the demand of the customer, you have to make that specific product. So here, specialization is very important because each and individual product which is being made by a company has certain specialized quality. So here, the specialization on which the product is being sold in the market. Now, what are the advantages of specialization? The first one is specialization and standardization leads to higher productivity. As you all know that by the help of specialization, you have certain specific and specialized product which is being there in the market, fulfilling the specific demand of a customer. If a customer wants a camera of 108 megapixel, so he is going to filter all the product which has got a camera of 108 megapixel. So somewhere or the other, the company has to maintain that it must have that specific feature in his mobile as well as the specific and standardized camera or lens for that feature so that the customer is being satisfied after taking the product. Then increases in output and reduction in per unit cost of production. As you say that if your function is being specialized, means all the camera, all the mobile phones which have got a specific range requires a specific range lens. So automatically the cost of overall product is somewhat equal to the product which is being there in the market. Because the product which a company is buying depends upon the raw material which a company is using for making his product. For 108 megapixel camera, you required a lens that is has got the same potential. So here overall, all the companies who are making mobile with 108 megapixel of cameras using somewhat same lens. So here the cost of overall production neutralizes. Then saving in purchase of raw material and improvement in the quality of the finished good. As you know that we are dealing with the specialization. So the cost of raw material also decreases because we buy certain specialized raw material which is being required for that specialized function. And as per the raw material is being used for that specific function, so the purchasing cost reduces and there is a saving in the purchasing cost. Now, what is the disadvantages of the specialization? The first one is less flexibility in adjustment to the change situation. When we follow about the standardized process that I have told you, if a mobile of 108 megapixel is being used, so you cannot increase the size or the dimension, you cannot decrease it because it has got some standard thing. So every standardized product has that only specified standardized activity which is has to perform. So you cannot change it. So there is less flexibility in the system. Then monotony and boredom may adverse affect the efficiency. As you all know that specific product perform certain standardized activity. So somewhere or the other, after some times the customer used to bore from that specific activity and may go for another product. So this is one of the drawback of the standardization specification. Then diversification. Diversification is somewhat when we require to change that our product is somewhat 3 year, 4 year, 5 year old, and now we have to make specific changes in the product and we have to go with that specific line of the product with certain changes. We used to say that we are diversifying our product. This is highly being seen in cars, in motorbikes, in mobiles. There are numerous examples in which we are going to see. Because as you see that Swift car, it has lot of changes from the inception to the present day. There are lot of changes which the company has given in that specific car. So it implies the policies of producing different types of product by an enterprise. Thus, it is a reverse of simplification as associated with the nature of the industry. It is just reverse of the simplification process. In simplification process, we use to make the product simpler for the customer. But in the diversification process, we use to give more activity, more product features in the specific product, which helps to attract more customer to buy that specific product. Now, what are the advantages of diversification? Increases in sales due to production of different kind of product. This also leads to increase in volume of the business. Means automatically when there is a diversification, the sale increases, and automatically there are different kind of product which is being there in the market, which helps the customer to have a wide range of variety to buy from that specific thing. Then needs of wider section of consumer are fulfilled. As you all know that different customers need a different line of the product demand. So here, by the help of diversification, we use to fulfill that demand of the customer. Risk minimization in the case of quick and unpredictable demand variations, uniform and a balanced production program can be chalked out without any consideration of wastage by production of the product. Means there must be a simple process which we can take into process in diversification. It helps to reduce the risk. The minimization of the risk has been done and the product line is simply maintained so that our product used to be come out in a diversified process with a less risk of damage. Now the last one is elimination of wastage by producing byproduct. As you all know that a company has a specific line system by which the product is going to be made. So here, by the help of diversification, elimination of wastage is being seen and the wastage is being reduced because the company is following the same product line and development of the product line. So the wastage is never being seen over there. Disadvantages of diversification. Due to increase in number of operations, the production process becomes quite complicated and sometimes expensive. As you all know, in diversification, we used to do research and development that what we can do to make our product more acceptable to the society, what are the new features which we can put in our product. So automatically, there is an increase in the cost and it might be that the cost of operation and the cost of production increases. Production planning and control operations become complicated and time consuming required extra effort. As you all know, I have told you research and development. So the production planning process requires a different time frame. It sometimes the product is being acceptable. It has to do a pilot survey, whether company has to do certain things to go into the market and check that what the customer needs. So it requires time. So they automatically for diversification of product, it requires certain specific time which a company has to give to make the product to the final output. Then the size and the variety of the item in the inventory increases with diversification, introducing more problems. Means whenever you are going to make certain new product, automatically you have to go with the certain inventory system. Till date, you are making just one mobile with 50 megapixel camera. Now you are going to make three mobiles with 50 megapixel camera, 80 megapixel camera, 108 megapixel camera. So your inventory is going to increase. You have to keep three lenses, three types of assets, everything. So your raw material, your inventory increases. So here the size and the variety changes when you go with the diversification. And the last one is the worker of different types of skills and expertise are required. When we go to diversification, as you know, diversification is somewhat changes in the product. So whatever changes which is being introduced in the product must have some expertise from the human resource who are going to put it in that specific product. So automatically to make it acceptable to that society, to the customer, you require the expertise human resource system. So somewhere or the other, diversification requires an expert set of human resource to employ in that specific company. So these are the four important aspects: simplification, standardization, specification, and diversification, which makes a product in its own quality to be acceptable in the system. And the more the product is standardized, the more the product is simple, it has got certain specific values, and it has got the time to diversify from time to time, we can say that product has got a lot of demand in the market. One such example is of laptops. The laptops which are able to upgrade from time to time is highly being acceptable in the market, rather than the laptops which are of a specific conditions you cannot change. So I hope that this is the whole area which we want to cover, that what is the profit, how you are going to make the profit, and how you are going to develop the product. So all these four aspects by which a product has been developed makes a product acceptable in the market, and the more the product is being acceptable in the market, automatically your profit increases. And the more the profit you are going to get, the more a company becomes innovative, a more the company becomes acceptable to the mass, and this increases the brand of a company. I hope you have understood. Thank you.